Hello students, welcome back. Welcome to your fifth semester of the three-year degree program. And I'm happy to invite you as a group to our online study of informatics. You know, informatics as a paper of a study in a program that is called English Language and Literature would have been unimaginable some 15 or 20 years back. But today, as in any other field of study, we just cannot overlook the importance of informatics or the computer revolution in our study of English language and literature. In fact, this very online classroom that we are now engaged in is nothing but a result of the computer revolution. Well, in this paper is divided into six modules, and I have been handled the latter three, that is modules 4, 5, and 6. You will be given a proper introduction to informatics by the teachers who handle the earlier chapters or the modules, particularly the first one. But in any case, before we go on to discuss the modules of 4, 5, and 6, I think it's only right that we understand what this course is all about. As you know, informatics is nothing but the science of information. It is a branch of study that studies the ways in which knowledge or information is synthesized. In other words, what are the ways, what are the patterns, what are the types of, you know, the production, storage, and communication of information. And, information technology Now, as we enter the world of information technology, let us begin on a pictorial note. I want you to take a good look at this picture, which is the work of an illustrator named Ella Baron. She mainly works or contributes to the Times Literary Supplement. And this is a work where she has, as you can see, taken images from the world of stories or literature and conveyed something about the world of information technology. Take a look at the picture and interpret it for yourself. Everything that we will be discussing during the course of this paper is, I think, depicted quite well in this image. So I leave the picture to you. Please do study it well and decipher it for yourself. Well, your syllabus is divided into 6 modules, and I will be handling the latter three, the ones on computer networks, knowledge resources on the internet, and localization. Computer networks is the first of our units for discussion. I really don't think we need to have a formal introduction to computer networks. Integrally involved as each one of you is in different kinds of computer networks, on your smartphones, on the laptops and the desktops that you might be using. Well, we are all part of such networks, and we just cannot live in a world without being participants in such networks. But for the purpose of this unit, let us begin with the concept of a network, which I think we can understand best when we compare and contrast it with a stand-alone computer, one which stands on its own, one which is capable of processing information, computing information, but ends with that. It cannot receive information from other systems, nor can it send information to other systems. So that is a standalone computer. But today, a standalone computer is more of an outdated thing because computers are all part of networks, that is, a linked set of computer systems that can communicate information. A computer network is a collection of computers and devices which are connected by channels of communication that enable communication among users and then allow the users to share resources with other users. A computer network is made up of both hardware and software. The major components of a computer network would be at least two computers, which are called the client workstations, a network interface card, NIC, which is installed in a computer so that it can be connected to the network, then cables, which help the computers to be connected to each other, even if it is a wireless system. Then you have the operating system, the main software that is needed, a network operating system like, for example, the Windows operating system or Linux operating system. Then a hub or a switch, a device that is used to connect the computer to a network. And then routers. Routers are gateway devices that connect multiple networks together. So these are basically the hardware and the software needed for a computer network to function. Networks can be of various types depending on their sizes. You know, we have a network, a very small personal area network, for example, your computer being connected to a printer. That is the example of a very minimal kind of network. A network can have a slightly bigger area of functioning. For example, you may have an entire building connected in the form of a network. You can have an internet cafe. You can have a whole educational institution connected in the form of a local area network. Or it can be a much wider area that is covered by the network, the whole country, for example, or the whole world. So depending on the size of the network, networks are broadly categorized into two major divisions, the local area network, LAN, and the wide area network, WAN. We'll discuss these different kinds of networks by and by. But before that, I think we need to take a look at the ways in which computer networks are arranged, you know, the technical aspect of it. So that is what is called the network topology. In other words, the way in which the network is arranged, the physical and the logical description of how the links and the nodes are set up so that they are connected with each other. And there are any number of ways in which a network can be arranged. For example, you can have the different units and the units connected in the form of a ring or the shape of a star, probably in a linear pattern like a line, or in the form of a bus as these pictures indicate. It is the specific need which dictates what kind of topology needs to be used. We don't need to go into the technology of creating a network. So we leave this topology here with the understanding that different situations require different kinds of interconnections or topologies. That's it. Computer networks are inevitable in our world today. But like everything else, it comes with its pros and cons too. Resource sharing, I think, would be the first major advantage of a computer network, something that we are all beneficiaries of. Secondly, there is a great deal of reliability that is ensured by a computer network, with a great deal of backup facilities available in the event of one system crashing and so on. Also, there is a great deal of uniformity that is ensured with the same kind of information being communicated to everyone and so on. Cost factor, you know, when you think of the great investment that you would have had to make otherwise in getting information, I think with a facility for resource sharing, the cost factor definitely is a major advantage. Increased performance, I think, is something that we witness every day, you know, with newer technology being made available by the day. We are getting more and more models of increased performance in computer networks. The storage capacity, you know, it is 100 times more compared to a standalone computer. With cloud technology and cloud computing becoming a reality, there is no limit to the storage capacity that we have at our disposal when we are part of a network. The communication medium is another very, very important advantage of a computer system, a computer network, because it enables speedy communication with emails and every other form of communication. But for all these advantages, I think there are some serious disadvantages that a computer network brings in within itself. One of the major drawbacks is, of course, the serious security issues that are involved. Compared to a standalone computer, computer networks create a lot of security issues. There is a great deal of theft that can happen. There is a great risk of hacking that can happen, and so on. So security would be a major issue. Second would be the spread of computer viruses. You know, that threat becomes more volatile when you are part of a system, a computer network, and it can crash each one of the systems. It can destroy each one of the system. Computer viruses, of course, which we will be discussing in greater detail, they are just malware. They are just programs that have the capacity to destroy your systems. And then when you think of the initial system, even though there is a great deal of economizing that a network enables, to initially set it up, of course, you need to shell out a great deal of money, and therefore the expensive setup should be considered as a disadvantage of a computer network. And finally, there is so much of dependency on the main file server. And if that should break down, then the whole system becomes useless. So that is the next major disadvantage.